Say, fella.
Huh?
This is the Latin class, isn't it? Latin language and literature. Thank you. Well, here we are in a Latin class. It's typical of classes all over the country. Why do so many of us study Latin? What can you get out of studying Latin? Let's see if we can find out. Miss Adams. Miss Adams, why should we study Latin? Why do you think we should study Latin?
Well, there are so many reasons, I hardly know where to begin. For example, I like to think sometimes of a farm boy who lived centuries ago on the plains of northern Italy. This boy tended his father's flocks. He loved the countryside. But as he worked, he dreamed. He dreamed of Rome, the greatest city in the world at his time. He dreamed of his country and of its history. And he worked to learn of its history and its language. That boy was named Virgil, and the language he learned was Latin. Years later, Virgil wrote the Aeneid, a great epic poem, telling of the legendary history of Rome and the ideals of Roman citizenship. Arma virumque cano, Troiae, qui primus arboris Italia.
Well, that's interesting, but there are translations, aren't there?
Oh, yes. My song is of war and a man. First from the shores of Troy he came, forced by fate from his homeland, and so on. Yes, there are translations, but none that quite match the original Latin for beauty of expression. Virgil wrote in Latin, and so did others. The soldier statesman Julius Caesar left us his own story of his campaigns. Cicero, statesman, senator, lawyer, has left us his essays, his speeches, and his theories of liberty that Americans still honor. And there were many others. Today we can read their works in translation or in the rich beauty of Latin. I studied Latin in order to enjoy this great literature more fully.
Where did Latin come from? Why was it so important as a language?
Latin was the language of the Roman Empire. But long before there was a Roman Empire, about 1000 BC, a number of nomadic peoples from the north entered Italy and some, called Latins, settled in the rich farmland south of the Tiber River. Soon a small commercial city grew up on the Tiber, the city we know as Rome. From about 500 BC onwards, Rome prospered, and its influence grew until about 100 AD, when almost all the civilized Western world was contained in the Roman Empire. Really, a Latin empire. Throughout much of this great empire, the Latin language was spread. Later, local tongues began to develop, direct descendants of Latin. Romanian, Italian, French, Spanish, Portuguese, and many lesser dialects. Latin also affected the languages of the Germanic peoples, among them the Angles and Saxons who later migrated to England and whose language became English. So we have a direct inheritance from the Latin.
But the Roman Empire collapsed. There's nothing left of it now.
Well, there's quite a bit left. For through the long years of the medieval period, Latin remained the principal language, the language of learning. The medieval church worshipped in Latin. Medieval monks copied the Bible and other important manuscripts in Latin. Medieval scientists recorded their observations in Latin. Medieval universities kept the light of knowledge burning in Latin. They taught the Roman law, the rules by which civilized men live. Our modern universities still pay homage to Latin. For example, in their mottos, In Deo Speramus, Veritas, Dei Sub Numine Vigit, and so on. So you see, Latin is also the key to a very important period of history. And Latin lives in our language and culture today.
Thank you, Miss Adams. But is that why the class is studying Latin?
Why not ask them?
All right. You, why are you studying Latin?
Well, I want to be a professional man, a doctor or a lawyer, maybe. Either way, Latin's important. You've heard these legal terms, habeas corpus, subpoena, but that's not the half of it. Listen, corpus delicti, per curiam, in toto, ex parte, pendente liti. Shall I go on?
That's enough.
Wait, I'll give you some medical terms that are Latin or come directly from Latin. You already know post-mortem. And of course, penicillin from the mold penicillium. And maybe you know some of these. Tibia, fibula, vena cava, corpus luteum. Well, and besides that, Latin's very important in all the science that you'll have to take before you study medicine.
All right. Latin's important if you're going into law or some scientific subject. But, well, how about you? Why are you studying Latin?
Well, I've always wanted to write, but I've been told that I don't have enough interest in words, in putting them together to make meaning. Understand?
I think so.
Well, I'm taking Latin to help that. And I really am getting interested, too. Why, just this morning I ran across a word I didn't know. Omniscient. I didn't have any idea what it meant. I could have looked it up, but this time I figured it out from Latin. Omni. That's from Latin, omnis, meaning all. And this is from the Latin, sciens, knowing. Omniscient, knowing all. Why, the study of Latin has done so much to broaden my vocabulary. Well, do you get the idea? Latin helps me understand English. Do you have any idea how much Latin there is in English? Take some of our finest writings. Take the Declaration of Independence, for example. Take out the words that come from Latin, and there's not much left. Latin runs right through our whole language. So, I'm taking Latin to help me understand and use English.
Yes, it sounds important if you plan to use and understand English. Now let's see. How about you?
Well, I'm not going to be a doctor or a lawyer or a writer. In fact, I'm not at all sure what I want to be. But you know, I do want to know more about where the basic principles of our government come from. Our way of life. The Latins founded Rome, and they were the leaders of the Roman Empire. And we've gotten a lot of our ideas from Rome. Why, just think. The Constitution. Our procedures for government. The way our government works. All these things reflect the political experience of the Romans, the theories of Cicero. Justice. Fair play. That's an idea the Romans developed. In ancient Rome, the law protected every citizen against injustice, and we've adopted that idea. Our law requires each citizen to be responsible for his actions and for the actions of his government. Well, the point is that by studying Latin, I can understand these ideas better, and so understand our democracy better. That's important to me. Besides that, later I may want to study some other languages. Spanish, maybe. Or French. Knowing Latin will make those languages a lot easier.
Well, there you are. Some of the most common and practical reasons for studying Latin.
And they're pretty convincing. Studying Latin could be a good idea.
Well, I think we'd better get on with our study.
And here is the starting point for your study of Latin. the key to languages.